watching ESPN Tryhard. Okay, so I'm here to discuss the chances of Cincinnati Reds making it to the playoffs. Unfortunately, last year they didn't make it in. They were shy getting into the playoffs. The NL Central wasn't the best league to be in, it's kind of mediocre. But the three-man teams are Peyton, for the St. Louis Cardinals, the Milwaukee Brewers, and of course the Cincinnati Reds. At one point, the Cincinnati Reds did have a large lead in the Central, but it dwindled down, and the Brewers and Cardinals started battling for it. And St. Louis got in the wild card and eventually won the World Series for shot. But this year, some of the changes to the roster, the biggest one was probably Edison Volquez. He moved to the San Diego, which I think was a good decision because he was one of the main reasons why Cincinnati didn't have a good success last year. This year they got to work on pitching, because that's what brought them down last year. If they would have good pitching, I think they would have made a longer stint. And would have probably made it to the playoffs and repeat the year before when they won the NL Central. Their hitting is tremendous. I couldn't ask for anything more, especially with Joey Votto. He's just phenomenal. He has amazing on base percentage, like he did last year at the same time. And even Brandon Phillips is getting his hitting done too. We're getting up and away in the plate and getting it in play and getting it through the hole. The pitching has improved since last year. They brought in Matt Rankin from San Diego. And at the beginning of the season, he had kind of a slow start, which, you know, going to a different league, different environment, you know, I kind of understood that he was at even on like a game or two, and gave up 3 or 4 runs each game, but, you know, that just happened, and now I think he's gotten used to being in the NL Central, pitching in Cincinnati. He's adapting to the Cincinnati environment, and he's doing a pretty good job of pitching right now. Johnny Cueto, the ace, has been pretty good. Fonsorario is had that slow start also at the year, beginning of the season, but he's controlling it. One of the main improvements from last year is also Aurora Chetney. And now they call him the key missile. He's got the 1-1 mile per hour fastball. And so far this season, he has 2 saves. And he's controlling the ball more, especially his fastball. He's keeping it in the strike zone as much as he can. And last year, it's staying in the strike zone. And he's been playing the strike zone for once. And I think he worked on that a little bit during the offseason. And he's getting good in a little bit. And he's getting more time to pitch. And he's getting really pitching and closing. We haven't seen Ryan Madsen much this year. He had Tommy John surgery during spring training, which is kind of sad. But Sean Marshall's closing, and I haven't seen him much, but from what I've seen, he's pretty good. The NL Central is, I'd say Cincinnati ends up winning it. Milwaukee doesn't have Prince Fielder. All they have is Ryan Braun and Ricky Weeks, and them talent alone isn't going to carry them for another pennant. The Cardinals, of course, with the big Albert Pujols trade, they're not going to get far. They're half a game behind the Reds right now, but it's not going to last long. Cincinnati's going to catch it to them and fly past them, and I see Cincinnati winning the NL Central. And so, this is my video. It's over with. Comment, rate, subscribe. This ESPN Tryhard. Adios.